मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट के मैप फॉर टू वेरिएबल्स ओके मा टू वेरिएबल के मैप व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ टू वेरिएबल के मैप that is having four number of cells okay ma that is having four number of cells one side we are taking the variable a and another side we are taking the variable b okay ma so this a having two possibilities those will be 0 and 1 B also having two possibilities. Those will be 0 and 1. Okay, ma. If you are taking the cell values, so this cell is 0 0 combination. So 0 0 means the value is 0. This cell is 0 1, so the value is 1. This cell is 1 0. That is A value is 1, B value is 0 here. Okay, ma. That's why this belongs to the value 2. Here A value is 1 and B value is 1. So this cell value is 3. Okay. So in the yesterday's class, we are taking some example on min terms. That means sum of product terms. Okay, ma? Sum of product terms we are taking. And how to minimize the Boolean expression for two variable expression. Okay, ma? So here we are taking two variable expression that is suppose if you are taking f is equal to the function f is equal to summation m of suppose if we are taking like this summation z m of 0 comma 1 comma two comma three okay ma here by observing this summation m is it belongs to sum of products or product of some min term or max term min term sum of products okay ma that's why here 0 1 2 3 means these are belongs to product terms that is equal to what is the meaning of this so what is the expression based on this a bar 0 means 0, 0. A value is 0, B value is 0. That's why A bar, B bar plus 1 means 0, 1. 0, 1 means A value is 0. That's why 0 means we are taking complemented form. 1 means that we'll be taking in uncomplemented form. 0, 1 means A value is 0, B value is 1. That is A bar, B. Okay? Plus 2 means 1 0. 1 0 means a value is 1, b value is 0. A value is 1, b value is 0. That is taking as a value is 1. That's why we are taking a. B value is 0. So taking as 0 means we are consider in complemented form b bar plus 3. 3 means 1 1. A value is 1, b value is 1. That's why we are taking a b. A value is 1, a. B value is 1, b. Okay, ma? So the meaning of this min term expression is equal to this is the Boolean expression. Okay, now this will be simplified. How to simplify this expression by using K-map. Okay, ma, by observing this only, you know how many variables are used in this Boolean expression. How many variables are there? Only two variables. Those will be A and B. Okay, ma? So those will be A and B. That's why I draw the two variable K map. Okay, ma? Draw the two variable K map. This is a two variable K map having four number of cells. Okay, ma? Here we are taking A. Here we are taking B. Here 0 and 1. Here B value is 0 and 1. Okay, ma? So here this will be 0-0 combination, that is A bar B bar. This will be 0-1 combination, that is belongs to 1. This cell belongs to 1-0, that is 2. This cell belongs to 1-1, that is 3. Okay, ma? If you are doing number of times like this, if you practice, then you will remember compulsory. Okay, so now observe this. What is the first term? A bar B bar. Okay, ma? What is the first term here? A bar B bar. So A bar B bar means that cell is this one. Next, A bar B. So this. So for each expression, for each term, we are putting one in the corresponding cell. Okay. So A B bar means which cell? 2. This cell. Next, A B. So this cell. Okay, ma? Now we are trying to group the adjacent ones. Okay, adjacent ones. If you observe here, so here four number of ones are here. Okay, four number of ones. So here one quad, are you remember? So if two number of ones are there, then that will be, if two number of ones are grouped, then that will be called as pair. Okay, in previous class we are taking example. So in that example we are grouped pairs only. Okay, here four number of ones are here. That's why here if four number of ones are grouped, then what is the name for that? Quad. Okay, ma? Quad. That is called as quad. So here there is a possibility to group four number of ones. Okay, that's why we are grouping these four number of ones like this. So one quad is formed here. Okay, here in this group covers which values of A? This group covers A equal to 0. This group contains A equal to 0 and A equal to 1 also. That means both are covered, A bar plus A. Okay, both are covered here. Okay, ma? So that's why A bar plus A, both are covered. That's why this group. If you observe, so in easily how to remember this means one column is completed here. Okay. One column totally A bar plus A. Okay, ma. So that value is 1 actually. So into, so here this group belongs to at which values of B? B equal to 0 and B equal to 1. Both are covered. That's why B plus B bar So what is A plus A bar value? 1. What is B plus B bar value? 1. 1 into 1 is equal to 1. So and the answer is here 1. So if you are taking this expression as a question, minimize this expression by using K map, then this is the procedure we are doing. We are getting the final answer is 1. Okay, ma, we are getting the final answer here is 1. Okay, are you understand? So here we are taking the min terms only. Okay, now suppose in the form of max terms, the expression is given. How to simplify that? Okay, ma, in this class we learn that. Okay, so if in terms of max terms, the expression is given, how to simplify by using K-map. Okay, are you understand this? So I erase this. Okay, Amma. Here we are taking in terms of max terms. Are you remember max terms? Max terms means that is in the form of pi m of some values. Okay, Amma. Are you remember? Here, if 0 is there, reverse, that means inverse, if 0 is there, that will be taking in uncomplemented form, uncomplemented, that is without bar. Okay, Amma? 1 is there, then that will be taking as complemented form, that is with bar. Okay, Amma? So that is remembered here. Okay, so now, take the general K-map for max terms. For 2 variables, here A B. A value is 0, A value is 1, B value is 0, B value is 1. Okay, Ma? So, what is the expression here we are getting here? Product of sum. Max terms means product of sum, POS. POS means here we are taking the sum terms in the cell combination. Okay, Ma? POS means product of sums. So that's why here, what is this corresponding cell? A is 0, B is 0. Here 0 is there, uncomplemented form. 1 is there, complemented form. Here A is 0, B is 0. That's why this cell is, this cell having the expression A plus B. Okay, Ma? If 0 is there, that will be taking uncomplemented form. If 1 is there, then that will be taking in complemented form. Okay, Ma, what is about this cell? A value is 0, B value is 1. A value is 0, that's why uncomplemented. A plus B value is 1. B value is 1 means that will be taking in complemented form. Okay, Ma, A plus B bar. What about this cell? A is 1, B is 0. So A is 1. That's why complemented form. A bar plus B is 0. That's why A bar plus B. Okay, Ma? Now here, A is at this cell, A value is 1, B value is 1. That is, both are in complemented. So that's why here A bar plus bar. Okay, Ma, this is the general K-map for max terms. Okay, that is product of sums. Product of sums. Okay, now we are taking one example here. How to do simplification? Okay, for this max terms, F is equal to a plus b into a bar plus b. Okay, now this is the expression given. This expression is simplified by using K-map. Okay, by observing this only, we understand, is this belongs to product of sums or sum of product? Product of sums. So that's why here we are taking this K-map. Okay, ma? This K-map. Here, draw the K-map. Here two variables are there. That's why two variable K-map is draw here. Okay. A B, here B value is 0, 1. A value is 0, 1. Okay, ma? Here A plus B means in this product of sums, inversely we are considering, because here based on the expression, we are putting 0 in that corresponding cell. Okay. Previously, in sum of products, what we can take? We are putting 1 in the corresponding cell, in the corresponding product term. Okay. Here we are taking the sum terms. That's why inversely we are taking here in this product of sums. Okay. That's why A plus B means what is the corresponding cell? This is the corresponding cell. Okay. At this corresponding cell, we are putting 0. Okay. If you are considering sum of products, previous example, 1 is putting in the corresponding cell. Okay. But here, this is belongs to max terms, that is product of sums. That means the corresponding cell having the value 0. Okay, ma? A bar plus B means which is the corresponding cell here? A bar plus B means this is the corresponding cell. Here also we are putting 0. Here we are grouping adjacent zeros only. Okay, ma? Here we are grouping adjacent zeros. Okay? So what are adjacent zeros here? These are adjacent zeros. Okay, ma? These are adjacent zeros vertically we are grouping this. Okay, so only one group is possible here. Okay, ma? Only one group is possible here. So now at this group, what is a value? What is a value? This group covers a equal to 0 and a equal to 1. That means a plus a bar, what is that value? 1. A plus a bar means that is 1. So what about B? This group covers which value of B? Only B equal to 0. Okay, ma? Only B equal to 0. Is this group belongs to B equal to 1? This is not belongs to B equal to 1. Only for B equal to 0 only we are getting the group. Okay. B equal to 0 means here only we are getting the expression as F is equal to. Here A means A bar plus A. Both are covered here. Okay. So that's why that value becomes 1. So no A variable is getting in the answer. Okay, that becomes 1. So B value is 0. B value is 0 means uncomplemented form or complemented form. Actually here we are taking. In this max terms, 0 means that we'll be taking as uncomplemented form. Okay, that's why actually see here. A is 0 means here this is A. A value is 1 means this is A bar Okay, Amma, like that here also. This belongs to B. Okay, this belongs to B bar. B equal to 1 means this is in max terms, product of sums. Okay, this is B bar. So this group belongs to only B. Okay, that's why here A value is 1 dot B. So what is the answer you will getting? That is equal to B. Okay, Ma? Are you understand? So actually the given expression is, this is the given expression. So by using Carnot map, we simplify this, then we are getting the answer is B. Are you simplified here? Are you simplified? In this way we are doing. So based on the groups only, we are getting the expression. Okay, Ma? Based on the groups only, we are getting the expression. Are you understand? We are taking another example in the same way. Okay? So A plus B into A bar plus B into dot. A plus B. Okay. Now this is the question. This is the expression, Boolean expression. Now this Boolean expression is simplified by using the K map. Okay, by observing this expression, or this is given in another way also. How that will be? How that will be? This is given in another way means. Here A comma B, A 0, 0. So 0. One, zero, two. Both are same. Take here bar. Okay. So this is the given expression. Okay, A, B values are 0, 0. That's why 0. A value is 0, B value is here. Sorry, A value is 1, B value is 0. Okay, here bar is there. Then that value is 1. If bar is not there, then that value is 0. Okay, Emma? So that's why. So here, this is 1, 1. So in this way also the question is given like this also. Pi of 0 comma 2 comma 3. Pi of 0 comma 2 comma 3 means, what is the meaning? 0 means 0, 0. 0, 0 means A value is 0, B value is 0. Okay? 2 means 1, 0. 1, 0. A value is 1, B value is 0. Okay? 3 means 1, 1. 1, 1. A value is 1. B value is 1. Okay, Ma? Here, you remembered one thing only. What is that? If 0 is there, uncomplemented form. 1 is there, complemented form. Okay, Ma? So now, here, based for this, we are doing the problem. First, draw the Carnot map for two variables. Because here, two variables are there. Okay? A B. 0, 1. Here, 0, 1. Okay? So, now putting. So, 0. What is the 0 cell here? That means here. See here. A plus B. A plus B means that is belongs to 0 here. Okay, so here this is A is 0 means this is A. Okay, here A is 1 means the corresponding is A bar. Okay, like this here also. This is B is 0 means that is represented as B. Here B bar. Okay, ma. Now A plus B. What is the corresponding cell? This is the first one is the corresponding cell, A plus B. Okay. So that's why here we are putting zeros. Remember here, max terms means we are putting zeros. Min terms means we are putting ones. Okay. So next A bar plus B. A bar plus B. So A bar plus B. This. So here also we are putting 0. Okay, ma, in the corresponding cell. A bar plus B bar. That is here A bar, here B bar. So here also we are putting 0. Okay, ma? Are you understand? So now here we are grouping adjacent zeros here. Okay, ma, we are grouping adjacent zeros. So what are adjacent zeros here? Okay. So, for that, in this example, this is one group. Okay, ma? This is one group. Take this as group 1. C1. Okay? Next, is there any other group here? Is there any possibility for other group? So, here also, these two are also adjacent zeros. That's why this will be taking as group 2. Okay, ma? Z2. So, observe first group 1. For this group 1, what are the values here we are getting? What are the A values? Here, this covers A plus A bar. Take this. This group 1. This is group 1. A plus A bar. Both are covered. That's why here 1 dot. So here B value is, this is only at B equal to 0. That's why this is B. Okay, ma? Here this is B only. So totally for the first group, we are getting the value B. Okay. So dot. What about this second group here? Second group. Second group. At this second group, what is A value? At this second group, what is A value? A bar. Okay, ma? So this is A bar. Okay. So what about B values here? This group covers B plus B bar. Both are covered. B plus B bar. What is this value for B now? 1. Okay. Now this is 1. That's why the answer here we are getting A bar dot B. Group 1 dot group 2. Okay, ma? Group 1 dot group 2. Okay? So, the result is this is A bar dot B. So, if this is the question given, by simplifying this question, we are getting the answer A bar dot B. Okay? Previously, in sum of products, we are taking the sums. Okay? Group 1 plus group 2. In sum of products, we are getting group 1 plus group 2. Okay? But here in this product of sums, we are getting group 1 dot group 2. Okay, this is belongs to group 2 dot group 1. Okay, Amma. In the same way here, if you are taking another term here, that is A plus B bar. If this is also added, then what we can do, the corresponding cell, this is also having 0. Okay, Ma? So here quad is possible. Quad is possible. So that's why here totally quad is possible. So no groups are there. Only one group, that is quad group. Okay, only one group, that is quad group. See. Okay, here what is the result you will be getting? This group covers A plus A bar, that is 1. This group covers B plus B bar also. So totally you will be getting the result F is equal to 1. Okay, Ma? F is equal to 1. Okay, are you understand here how to reduce the Boolean expressions by using two variable k-map here? Okay, Amma, only one thing is remembered. If you are considering the expression in sum of products, then we are putting the 1 in the corresponding cell. Okay, if you are taking the expression in product of sums, then we are putting 0 in the corresponding cell. In the same way here, in sum of products, we are grouping number of adjacent ones. Okay. That means in powers of 2 only, 2 ones, 4 ones, 8 ones, 16 ones, like that. So like that, in product of sums, we are grouping zeros, adjacent zeros, that is 2 zeros, 4 zeros, 8 zeros, 16 zeros. Okay. Is that group covers how? What are the variables? A bar A, B bar B. Okay. So based on that, you will be grouped and based on that, you will be getting the simplified expression. Okay, Ma, are you understand? All of you practice this yesterday class and today's class. Up to this, two variable K-map is over. Okay, Ma, next class, we start the three variable K-map. Okay, all of you practice yesterday class and today's class and listen the videos if you are having any doubt. Okay.